Welcome back, everyone. Today we are going to work on the wife's four-wheeler. And it's been running really good. We had it up on the trails a few times. Put a new chain on it, sprockets, all that stuff. I rebid the top end on this. I don't know if you can see it, but that head's brand new. Piston and rings and all that stuff. She runs good. She's quick. It's a 250 Raptor, and the wife loves it. Today, we are going to replace. I don't know if you can see that very well there. Put some light on it. We're going to replace the rotor for the disc and the pads, as you can see. Now that you've seen that awesome display of donut tree, these are the parts that I picked up for her quad. Race driven riptide rotor. By race driven industries, I guess you'd call it. This is the riptide. It's a little bit fancier than the one that's on there. I don't think it's really going to matter too much, but a little fancier anyway. These are the brake pads. So that's the plan for today. Let me get you set up in a stand and we'll get at it. Let's give this a shot, see what happens. I'm not very confident, but we'll see. So I'm gonna use a pipe, try to crack these, and I have the breaker bar set up inside the axle to keep it from turning. This is the plan anyway. Oh, beautiful. Got that one to pop. Let's try this top next one. Very nice. Alright. We can get the next two. Beautiful. So here's the rotor, and you guys can get a pretty good look at it here. This side is really smooth, doesn't look bad at all. This side, on the other hand, is completely gone. Needs to be replaced. So we're gonna replace it with this guy right here. Let's get a look this guy. And this is a pretty nice piece as well. Same thickness, 3 mil. Yeah, looks good. Looks real good. I don't see a directional, anything directional on this. So I'll put the letters out. What do they say? All right, I'm gonna go. Let's go mount this on the bike. Right, a little bit closer. See if that helps. I think what I'm gonna start with is cleaning everything off. I'm gonna wipe this down a little bit. I'm gonna hit that with some new grease, and I'm going to clean these areas as well. So I'm just gonna hit it with a wire brush. Get all the stuff off. I'm going to grab some blue Loctite. I'll be right back. So, let's install the rotor, or disc, whatever you guys want to call it. And I have the blue red locker that I'm going to use on these bolts, because I'm pretty sure there was red lock on them by the way they came off. Vibrating out, so we will use red lock and put them back in. Snug them up by hand. Again, put a little bit of thread lock on in there. Down the axle so it doesn't spin. Yeah, I'll tighten it this way. So I'm gonna lock it at the top here. I'm not gonna go crazy, because I don't want these things. I mean, they're just Allen heads and I don't want to strip the hex. So that's good. That's good. One more. One. And we'll just double check it. And that's good. Alright, let's compress piston for the brakes. Just gonna push it in a little bit because the new brake pads have more meat on them. I'm just using a little standard sequence, nothing fancy. And I'll just push that in slowly. See that going in? Not taking a lot of force here. I mean, I'm barely putting anything on that at all. I'm gonna turn it till it seats. That should do it right there. Alright. Let me grab the new pads. Got new pads, and I think looking here, there's usually a clip in there. All right, the clip's still in there. Didn't come out, so that's good. So I'm gonna pop in the first pad. Goes in like that. The second pad goes in like this. And then your slides go in. And let me just double check to make sure that it's there. Same before I come in. Each got a hole in them. Alright, so what I'm going to do here is, on these slides, wipe them off, wipe the debris off. You want these to be able to slide, and I'm going to use the same stuff you use for automotive brakes. And these are slide lubricating grease for disc brakes on a car. And they're pretty much the same thing. No different, really. They operate the same way. So I'm going to put a little bit of this grease on here, just like that, and I'm going to move it all around there, get that nice and lubricated. This will allow the brake pads to slide. Now, who knows, maybe that other pad, you know, on the old brakes, maybe it was jammed. Maybe it locked up on the slide. That's why it was one on one side and not the other. I don't know. So I'm going to go this way. First one's in. There we go. Start it. Same thing on this one. Get the grease out of there. I mean, it's important not to half-ass when you're working on these things. I know a lot of people are lazy or whatever and take shortcuts, but I don't advise that. Get extra time, do it right. Just gotta snug these up at the moment. Disc. Put a little bit of Loctite on the caliper bolts. Now this is removable Loctite. It's not the red, it's the blue. I use the blue because you're gonna want to take these apart again if your pads go. And you want to be able to do that. You don't want it permanently on there. But you don't want it to come off either while you're riding, so. The blue does that, and also, believe it or not, protects the threads from corrosion. So, put that on there. Tighten these up. Give it a couple of whacks with the hand to make sure it's snug. You don't have to kill it. Good. I'll torque these down. That's good. Before I bend those tabs, I'm going to come over. I'm going to hit the brake a few times to get that cylinder to touch. Grabbing.
good.
All right. Gonna put some fresh grease on this blinds here. Looks like there was a white lithium grease on there. This is outdoor tractor grease, the green stuff. I prefer this, honestly. Alright. Slide this back on. What I'm doing here is just lining the castle nut up with just a spot hole. Make sure it's all the way through. That should do it. Kind of breaking my own rule here. I usually don't reuse cotter pins, but this pin is brand new. So, we'll use it. Grab a little extension because it was just far enough where I only wanted to an angle. Extension. Put you guys over here so you can see. That's it. And that's how you change the rear disc and the rear pads on a 2008 Raptor 250. Well, just want to show you guys that I bent those tabs over after I put the wheel on. Just wanted to make sure that you guys knew I didn't try to do that. And
that's about it.
All right, the only thing left now, take it for a ride.